Welcome to Continued Dokken Capture release video. My name is Mikkel Resbøl. I'm the Dokken Capture Senior Product Specialist at Continued Software. In this video, we will go through some of the awesome new features in Dokken Capture 450. Before we get started, let's see what we have on today's menu. This session is based on NAV 2017 with Dokken Capture 450. The most important subject is, of course, the new features in Dokken Capture 450. Dokken Capture has been enhanced with lots of cool new stuff from head to toe. The agenda clearly states that we have enough to deal with today. Please notice that the new features and changes are described in the documentation that comes with the installation package. Let's get the show up and running by taking a closer look at the news in Dokken Capture 450. We start out with the installation process of Dokken Capture. The number of standard objects that are modified by Dokken Capture is once again greatly reduced. In former versions, you had to merge 10 standard objects. Now the number of objects is down to 7 in total. 3 tables and 4 pages. That's in a NAV 2017 environment. This means that the code unit 90, purchase post, and page 345, navigate, no longer contains any Dokken Capture code. A new feature that makes the installation of Dokken Capture much easier is that both the client components and server components are automatically installed. The components guide themselves to the right location when they are automatically downloaded from Continua Online. Please notice that this feature only applies to NAV 2017. Another nice feature in version 450 is that Continua Dokken Capture can be installed as an extension in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2017. This opens the possibility to add new functionality to the database without changing any of the standard objects, which will make implementations in both on-premise and hosted environments much easier. Please notice that installing Continua Dokken Capture as extension limits the possibility to customize the program code. We therefore recommend that you as a partner conduct a thorough evaluation internally before you implement our new extension in a customer project. When looking into the Dokken Capture setup, it is clear to see that something has changed. When setting up Dokken Capture, we have fewer file paths to consider. The file types TIFF, PDF, and email are now archived in the same file folder, the archive file path. The documents and other attachments can now be stored either in the NAV database or in a file folder. Choosing database as a storage type will make Dokken Capture store the files in a blob field in a NAV table. This makes it possible to install Dokken Capture in a hosted environment like Asia, where you don't have a file archive at your disposal. With all the files and attachments stored inside the database, the installation and upgrade of Dokken Capture is made even easier to complete. When changing the storage type to database, Dokken Capture informs you that the documents are to be automatically moved to the new location. Just answer yes, lean back, and let Dokken Capture handle the task. Let's take a look at the document category card. In the OCR processing panel, we have two new settings: max number of pages to process per file, and OCR export code page. In earlier versions of Document Capture, the TIFF file was automatically shortened. This only inflicted the viewing of the document in the nav client, making it a bit difficult for the nav users to see all pages. The new field max number of pages to process per file now allows you to set up a maximum number of pages the TIFF file may contain. The original setting of 200 pages is applied to the field as a default value. If you want to heighten or lower the value, simply change the number. The other new field, OCR export code page, enables you to control which code page is used when the OCR engine generates the result of the OCR processing. Adjusting this setting might come in handy when dealing with documents that contain characters not included in the database code page. The setup regarding Continue Online is entirely changed. New pages and tables to handle the setup of client ID, web portal, and company activation are introduced. The client ID for each company is entered through the page Continue Client Credentials. The Continue Client Credentials page holds all the client IDs used in any company throughout the entire database, making it possible to set up multiple client IDs in the same database. This enables you to have both test and production companies in the same database. The page Continue Web Portal List is where the web portal setup is configured. Here you can set up and manage multiple website settings to be used for the different companies in the database. To combine the client ID with the web portal setting, you just need to open the Continue Company Setup page and choose the client ID and web portal code. Please notice that Continue Company Setup is the location where you enter the company code. When everything is configured and activated, the full list of company registration is viewable in the page Continue Online Company Activation. This page shows a complete list of which companies are activated and registered at Continue Software. Based on input from the users of Document Capture, the permission sets have been reviewed and adjusted. The permission sets now include a setup that matches the most companies' need for setting up user rights when it comes to document handling with Continue Document Capture. The permission sets DC All, DC Super, and DC Web are updated in Document Capture 450. In multiple areas of Document Capture, the layout of the pages is enhanced. This is done by hiding page parts and buttons that are irrelevant. If you take a look at the ribbon in the document journal, the Navigate button is not visible when looking at open documents. The view is changed to show registered documents. The Navigate button is presented. Besides the Navigate button, the Move to Company button is only visible if more companies are set up and activated with Document Capture. If only one company is active, the Move to Company button is hidden. Moving down to the list of the documents, we'll find some more interesting features. The column order return order is only shown if the company contains any non-posted purchase orders or purchase return orders. One of my personal favorite enhancements in Document Capture 450 is the ability to sort and filter the view based on the vendor number and vendor name. Just click on the column header or other columns to sort the list. You can also right-click on the list or add the filter pane to set a filter on the desired value. It's much easier now to look up documents from a specific vendor in the document journal. Looking at the match line page, a minor but important improvement is applied. The panel showing recognized document lines is only visible if any lines are actually recognized. Change the template settings and run the recognize fields function. When looking into the match line page, the view of the match line page is changed to fit the setup of the template. Just like in the document journal, the approval entries page also supports sorting and filtering of the view. Simply add the filter or click directly in the list and set your filter. Besides the already mentioned new features, Document Capture is enriched with some general enhancements. Over the next few minutes, I will go through three of the new cool improvements. The support for electronic payments is expanded to include not only the Danish payment type FIK, but also the Norwegian payment format KID. Besides adding the Norwegian KID format, the existing Danish FIK recognition is significantly improved. Another area of Document Capture that also is improved is the Purchase Order Match and Purchase Return Order Match. Numerous improvements are added to the matching functionality, both the manual and automatic match procedures. The third exciting feature I would like to mention is the option to add attachments to Document Capture pages directly from Outlook. You no longer have to place the file on your desktop before adding it to Nav. Just grab the file from the email and drag it over to the Document Capture file fact box. No need to get irritated over Outlook any longer. The track is clear and we can get our work up to speed. So, what have we been through today? First, we reviewed many of the awesome new features in Document Capture 450. Then we looked at several cool new features in Document Capture and continue online setup, as well as some nice general improvements. That's all that I had today's menu. Thank you for viewing. Hope you enjoyed the video. Continue Software wishes you a great day.